This experiment is a videotape of the electrostatics experiment. And there are two files you need to download before you watch the experiment. One is a set of instructions, and the other is a report form that has the questions on it you'll need to answer. The experiment involves charging by two methods, conduction and induction. In the process of conduction, the object is allowed to touch the object, it's the charging object, and in induction it is not. The first thing we're going to do is to acquaint you with what happens and how the object responds when it's brought near a charged object. So step one, we're going to rub this plastic rod with a piece of glass, piece of wool, and bring it near to the object. Watch what happens to the object. And we didn't want it to touch it, but that's okay. All right, as long as it's not, as it doesn't touch it, we're in good shape. We bring this up and you see what happens. All right, now we're going to do the same. You should answer question one. Now for step three, we're going to rub the charge the glass rod positively. In step four, we'll bring it near the object, and you can see what happens there. So you should answer question two now. Now we're going to charge the rod, rubber or plastic rod again, and bring it near enough and allow it to touch it. Okay. That was step five. Observe what happens. Step six, we're going to charge the glass rod again positively and bring it in there. See what happens. Of course, see, it's quite intense there, isn't it? Observe what happens and answer question four. Now we're going to charge the rubber rod again and bring it near enough to the object. Observe what happens. That took too long. We took too long to do that. I need to repeat part of that. So let me go back and repeat steps five. Step five, I charge the rubber rod. Start out with a discharged object. Charge the rubber rod. Bring it near. It touches it. That wasn't very good. Let's see if I can get a better charge in here. I like it. Okay. That's a good charge. And let's do this one fairly quickly this time. When I bring this near, charge it, bring it up. You see it's attracted quite strongly. Now if I bring this one, charge it again, bring it back up there, you see what happens. Okay. So as we bring that, you can answer question six. Discharge the object now. In step nine. Step 10, we're going to charge the glass rod. I discharged that. Okay. We're going to charge the glass rod and bring it back and allow it to touch. All right. And observe what happens there. In step 11, the rubber rod. We charge the rubber rod and bring it up, and of course it's observe what happens and answer question number eight. In both of those cases, we allowed the object to touch the rod. First the rubber rod and then the glass rod. And so they acquired charges in that process of touching. It's called the process of conduction. Now we're going to do it by induction, the process of induction, in which case we do not allow the object we're charging to touch the charging object, the rod. So we're going to charge the rubber rod. I'm going to hold this in my hand, bring it near to it like this, and then move it away. All right. Now, that was step 12 and 13. We're going to charge the glass rod and bring it in there now. And when I do so, you see what happens to the glass rod. Not the glass rod. What happens to the object itself? Okay. Answer question 10. Now I'm going to discharge the object. And I'm going to charge that was step 15, discharging the object. Step 16, I'm going to charge the glass rod and bring it near to the charging object that I'm holding in my, near to the object that I'm holding in my hand, and move it away. That. Now let's see what I've got. That was step 16. Step 17, charge the rubber rod and bring it up near it, and you see what happens. Observe what happens and answer question 11. So in the two parts of the experiment, in each of the last two, we did not allow it to touch the rod. I held it in my hand and then moved this away before this could touch it. But we still got a charge. And things are different there from in the induction process and the conduction process. That's it.